one of the common tenets in our society is the idea that anyone can kind of achieve upward mobility, that anybody who puts their mind to it or works hard enough can rise above the circumstances that they grow up in and can achieve success in life, and that's kind of within your control. There's a subgroup of youth, of low-income Black youth, who appear to be successful on the outside or by a lot of external metrics. So they are the ones who have graduated college, who have gone on to get good jobs, who are earning high incomes, and they appear to be successful in many, many ways when you look at external metrics, and they seem to be essentially kind of our success stories. They usually look quite good in terms of mental health profiles. They have low levels of depression, low levels of substance use. So above the skin, they're what we call resilient, or they've overcome the odds, and they've achieved a lot of successes in their lives. When we look below the skin or underneath in terms of their physiological systems or in terms of their health, these same exact youth appear to be at greater risk for a number of health problems, physical health problems in adulthood compared to other, for example, low-income youth of color who don't achieve those same kinds of successes. So it's resilience that is only above the skin and not below the skin, and that's why we call it skin-deep resilience.
Stress can activate certain biological systems like your sympathetic nervous system, which is your fight or flight response, like your hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, which releases cortisol. So both these systems release hormones like epinephrine, norepinephrine. These hormones in turn signal immune cells to start a kind of inflammatory response.
They have what's called faster epigenetic aging. Epigenetic aging is a way of reflecting your biological age relative to your chronological age. And so when your biological age looks to be faster than your chronological age, it's an indicator of weathering, or the idea that biologically you're aging faster than you should be given your actual age. It's one of the phenomena that we think is going on with skin-deep resilience individuals. They're more likely to have diabetes, they're more likely to have metabolic syndrome, they're more likely to get a common cold after being exposed to a virus, they're more likely to have elevated levels of inflammation compared to low-income Black youth who don't go to college or who aren't high strivers. People who are higher in socioeconomic status as adults experience better health across a variety of different types of outcomes. So it kind of makes sense that if you're somebody who achieves upward mobility as an adult, you're in a higher SES bracket, you should have better health. But they're more likely to have worse physical health than even low-income white students who make it to college, for example. The idea that as you're striving for successes and working so hard, you're also moving into these spaces that are set up by higher socioeconomic status people, and you're becoming more likely to encounter, for example, discrimination and microaggressions. And as a result, one way of coping with those sorts of stressors is through certain unhealthy habits like overeating of comfort food, for example, or engaging in substance use as a way of dealing with the negative emotions that surround stressors that you experience in your life that are just out of your control. One big explanation for it is a lifetime and accumulation of race-related stressors that Black Americans experience that white Americans aren't exposed to in the same sorts of ways. And so a big part of that comes from discrimination that's at the institutional level, as well as discrimination that's at the interpersonal level. And the idea is that these kinds of life experience create stress on individuals, and these psychological stressors take a physiological toll on their bodies. in our research, we're starting to look at some of these mechanisms. So we have a longitudinal study that we're doing here in Chicago of low-income Black youth from around the Chicagoland area, where we're following them over a two-year period to track kind of both the developmental picture of skin deep resilience, so kind of how and when it emerges and why, you know, and so we're tracking a number of different factors to see which things might turn out to be the strongest contributors to the skin deep resilience pattern.